Hey guys, technically Jeff here, and I wanted to do a quick video series talking about the cost of EV ownership versus a gas vehicle, just because I think there's a common misconception out there that, and I know I've heard it, if you have an electric vehicle, can't hide money. And not only is that a little annoying, but it's also not necessarily the case. It can be somewhat cost effective to own an EV, depending on your circumstances. So I'm going to do a few different videos talking about the cost of owning an EV. This is the first video. This is going to talk about the cost of charging versus the cost of gas. So as we all know, the cost of gas has been skyrocketing lately. So this is really going to show favorably for EVs. And unfortunately for a lot of people out there, the cost of gas doesn't seem to be looking like it's going to be coming down anytime soon. So hopefully this is helpful in helping you decide if this is something that you could potentially afford. So in these estimates, I'm just going to go through it, break it down pretty simply for you. The yearly miles that I'm doing this first one based on is just 10,000. I know most people nowadays drive a little bit more than that. So this one won't show quite as favorably for EVs, but it's still a pretty significant savings. So 10,000 yearly miles is 833 miles per month. The cost per kilowatt hour I'm going to base it on is 12 cents. That is from what I've seen the national average. I've seen as high as 14 cents per kilowatt hour. I've seen as low as 9 cents. And then, of course, there's time of use charging that some people have access to depending on your utility provider, where if you charge, say, between 12 a.m. and 6 a.m., it's much cheaper, but most people don't have access to that. So I'm going to do it based off of 12 cents per kilowatt hour and 3.2 miles per kilowatt hour for the efficiency. Most EVs are in the 3 to 4 range, depending on how much highway driving you do and your climate. And this is actually something that doesn't play as big of a part as you might think. So, but anyway, for these calculations, I'm going to do 3.2. And I'll show you some less efficient EVs, how that would impact it as well. And then the cost per gallon as of this week is $4.95 per gallon of gas for regular in the United States, which is very high, highest I've seen in my lifetime. So I'm going to do it based off of $4.95 for the cost per gallon. And efficiency, I'm going to do a conservative 25 miles per gallon average. Most vehicles out there average in the 22 range, combined city and highway. But again, I'm going to be conservative and do it based off of 25. I'll also do a couple of different estimates here for you so you can see how it impacts things. So based off of all of this, the cost for 1 month of electricity for charging a vehicle, an EV, would be $31.25, and a gas car would be $165. So that equates to a monthly savings of $133.75. Pretty substantial. Yearly, that's over $1,600, and that's based off of 10,000 miles per year. So you drive 15,000, which is a little bit closer to the average for most people. That monthly savings increases to over $200 per month, and this is just in the cost, the savings of electricity versus gas. And now this is also based off of 25 miles per gallon. Let's say you have a SUV that's a few years old that averages, say, 20 miles per gallon, and you still drive 15,000 miles per year. At this point, you're saving over $260 a month just by switching from that vehicle that gets 20 miles per gallon to an EV with an efficiency of 3.2, and you drive 15,000 miles a year. Now, let's say that you get an EV that is less efficient, or you floor it all the time, like some of us might do. Or you are in a climate where it gets very hot or very cold and you have to use a lot of AC or heat. Let's say your efficiency drops all the way down to 2.5 miles per kilowatt hour. You're still saving almost $250 a month. That's why I was saying the efficiency for the electric car doesn't play as big of an impact as you might think. But as you can see, it's pretty substantial. There can be a lot of savings, especially the more you drive. Because obviously the more you drive, the more of an impact that you'll see. Let's go back to the 3.2 here. And let's say that you still get 20 miles per gallon. Let's say you're driving more like 20,000 miles a year, which I know a lot of people do. 20,000 miles a year, switching from a vehicle that gets 20 miles per gallon to an EV, you're saving $350 a month, $4,200 a year. That is a ton of money. There are some inexpensive EVs out there that, I mean, $350 a month would make up most of that car payment. It's it's substantial. So anyway, next time that you are talking to somebody about EVs or anything like that, be sure to share this with them. Let them know that, yeah, some EVs are expensive, but there's a lot of different things out there that can help offset the cost of EVs. And the cost of electricity versus the cost of gas is a big factor. And like I said, right here, this particular estimate, $350 a month savings. And honestly, this isn't unrealistic. This is somebody switching from a vehicle that gets 20 miles per gallon to just a normal EV and driving 20,000 miles a year charging at their house. Now, one thing I do want to talk about is if, say, you can't charge at your house very often, you have to do a lot of public charging at like Electrify America. So Electrify America, they in a lot of states do pricing per kilowatt hour, but it's 43 cents a kilowatt hour without their charge pass, or you can buy their charge pass and it is 31 cents a kilowatt hour, but that costs $4 a month. So let's say that you only charge Electrify America, just to see what the savings would be. At 31 cents a kilowatt hour, 10,000 miles a year, switching from a vehicle that gets 20 miles per gallon, you're saving $125.52 still at this point, driving 10,000 miles a year. Now you got to add in the $4 cost of that charge pass. So $121 of savings monthly. Let's say you're driving $20,000 or 20,000 miles per year. The savings doubles to over $250 a month in savings, only fast charging at a DC fast charging Electrify America charging station. Take out that $4, you're still almost 250 bucks a month in savings. So anyway, just wanted to share this with you guys. There's gonna be more videos coming talking about EV versus gas and the cost effectiveness of it and what you can potentially do to help save money and offset the cost of switching to an EV. But I just wanted to share this with you guys. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you have any questions, let me know. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.
If you like this video, please hit that like button and subscribe and follow me on all social media. Thanks for watching.